again, welcome back. It sounds too good to be true, but nevertheless, it is. This pink powder that you can see over there on the table is freeze-dried extract of what is known as the miracle berry. And the miracle is that it alters your taste buds to make even the sourest stuff, like vinegar or lemon juice, taste wonderfully sweet. You put it on your tongue, like we just did during the break. We haven't tasted any of this stuff yet, so we don't know, but we are told that lemons taste like toffee, vinegar like sherry, and Guinness apparently tastes like chocolate milkshake. There's a huge internet rush on this stuff now, largely due to journalist and writer Tom Mangold, who recently made a documentary all about it. And he's here now with wine expert Ollie Smith, who can explain what the berry does to our taste buds. Apparently it destroys the taste of wine, which is one of the reasons why you're not having any tonight, because you're going
absolutely true. I'm hoping to have a glass of wine afterwards, and I have had it. I hadn't had the freeze-dried stuff. I had the real berry.
Right. Okay. Can you tell us about it? What is it? Just a little berry growing somewhere
in Africa?
It's
a very small berry. It's about the size of an olive. It grows on the west coast of Africa. It was discovered in 1725. The locals ate it because their food wasn't very nice, and it helped lift the food. And it was finally taken up in 1974 by a couple of American entrepreneurs who realized its huge, and I mean huge, potential.
For what? For entertainment?
Well, because you can have no. You can have junk food without the junk. This stuff is better than sugar. They ran a double-blind test on school children in Boston using iced lollies. Half of them had iced lollies with sugar, half of them had iced lollies with a miracle berry. All the kids preferred the miracle berry.
Which is not nearly as harmful as processed sugar.
No calories.
Okay. And it doesn't sort of rot away at your teeth or anything like
Absolutely
that?
Absolutely not. So obviously both big sugar and big saccharin got very, very worried about it.
So that kind of lobby is presumably why we haven't seen more of it since the
70s. Well, that's a conspiracy theory, but I do think there may be something to it. There certainly was in the mid-70s.
Well, before we have a taste test, we've got lemons, we've got vinegar, we've got wine, Guinness, a couple of other things. Ollie, what does it do? Unlike spices or sugar, you don't mix it with food. You put it, well, you can do, but for the purposes of this, you can just put it straight on your tongue about 2 or 3 minutes before you start to imbibe or eat. And what does it do to the taste buds?
It physiologically, it changes the way you taste. And for me, this is really exciting, but I'm also absolutely terrified. I've no idea exactly what it's going to do. But what it does is bind to your taste buds with a substance called miraculin, which you find in there.
And
it basically, it's a brilliant name, isn't it? But the name of the berry itself, Sinciplum dulcificium, it sounds like a Harry Potter spell.
Yeah,
I just think it couldn't be more miraculous. But it basically alters the way you taste. In your palate, you've got sweet, sour, savoury, bitter, and you've got all those things going on, salt, all those things to taste. This one reverses sweet with sour.
Okay. Well, in that case,
anything could happen.
Let's all get hold of a nice slice of lemon. We put a lot on during the break.
I've had quite a lot.
I'm a bit nervous
here we
now.
Go. I'm really
this
nervous.
This should taste horrible.
It should taste, well, sweet, I think.
Oh, it's gorgeous. Oh, it tastes like
thrilling.
This fantastic lemonade.
It's like a beautiful lemon jelly.
When I had it, it tasted like a meringue.
Mm.
Yeah.
Gorgeous, isn't it? Just like a meringue.
Lemons are really good for you.
This is great.
This is remarkable.
Thank you, Africa.
So when you order abroad a citron pressé, which is one of my favourite drinks, which is fresh lemon with water, I have to drown it with sugar to make it even palatable.
Take some of this.
But if I had some of this,
if you had this before, absolutely, it'll make it taste absolutely delicious.
Have you done the vinegar taste test?
I've done the vinegar, and it tasted like cheap vodka. Subject on which I can speak for hours.
Judy?
Here we go.
Okay, so this is
it smells properly of vinegar, I'm not sure, right?
It smells of vinegar.
It smells of vinegar.
Possibly tastes good, because 70% of your flavours come from
olfactory
receptors. Oh, down the hatch. That's still pretty sharp.
It's still a bit sharp.
That's still pretty sharp.
It's not tasting enough. It's doable. You can,
Oh, my goodness me. I think we need to take a little bit more of the magic pink powder.
It burns a little on the gullet.
Right.
But on the tongue, it's fine. Do you need to we take some more powder?
Yeah, let's do it.
Let's do some.
I'm in if you are, Richard. Absolutely.
You are. Well, let's get into this.
This is beginning to look a bit suspect.
It's phenomenal. You don't know what you're missing, really. Miracle berry.
It's true. There's a lot of middle-class dinner parties in America where this, if you like, is the harmless.
Yes, I went to, well, it wasn't a dinner party, but I went to a miracle berry party in Washington to do the radio documentary, and they had all these things spread out rather than the way that you have. Mm-hmm. And it was fascinating, but there is there's an immediate downside, which is that it lasts for about 2 hours. And nobody's quite cracked that yet. They don't know how to deal with that. It kills wine stone dead. Well, I can tell you that now,
before
you have it. Forget it. Wine.
Really? What's it going to taste like?
Like goat's thing.
Goat's urine.
Okay. Great. Well,
you're a wine buff.
I am
so
a wine buff.
So you give us a description of this.
All right, I will do. Here we go.
Smells of wine.
Oh, my goodness me, that's acrid, rank, utterly disposable. Yeah. Don't go there, people. Do not mix the miracle.
It's like stuff with antifreeze, isn't it?
I tell you something, it's not big sugar or big cyclamen that will go for you. It's big wine that will try and stop this.
It's so bad. It's tragic.
And,
it's so
and
bad
the problem is... The problem is now this will stay with you for about 2 hours.
Oh, right? That's why you're not taking it. You've got
that's
a
why I'm not taking it.
Well, what does this mean we can drink over the next 2 hours? We need to find something brilliant that we can drink over
well,
the next 2 hours.
Well, this is Guinness. Now, we've been told this makes this taste chocolatey.
Absolutely.
OK, well, let's bring it on. Cheers.
Cheers.
Down the hatch.
It does. I can still taste the Guinness.
It's like Nesquik with alcohol.
It's the finish, though, that's chocolatey. The first hit is very Guinnessy. But afterwards, it's much creamier, much more chocolatey. Mm. Delicious.
But if I had my eyes closed, I'd say this was like fizzy Nesquik or a fizzy Cadbury's chocolate drink, to name many other popular brands, which, as it goes down, turns back to Guinness.
It's amazing how the trickery works, because it's our little antennae on our palate that are literally just being fooled into thinking.
Remember, there's a whole serious side to this.
Yeah.
You know, potentially...
That's why you're here, Tom, to keep us grounded.
I'm a serious guy.
OK.
First of all, in terms of diabetes, this has got huge potential for diabetics. Enormous. Mm. In terms of having junk food without the junk, in terms of dealing with obesity, which is, after all, a pandemic now, this has got huge potential.
And can it be grown sort of en masse? Can you get
yes,
large
it
crops
can.
Of this?
Well, in the 70s, it was grown in Jamaica and Puerto Rico. They're growing it now in Florida. I haven't tried the freeze-dried version. I've tried the actual berry, which you can get through the internet as well. But the potential is enormous.
Can you order the seedlings? Can you grow it in your greenhouse?
No.
No,
it has to. No, it's a fussy plant, and the berry doesn't survive very long. So
some people have even said that it might help chemotherapy patients to get a nasty taste in
the metallic
mouth.
Taste goes away. Exactly.
Yes.
So it does with the Brussels sprouts.
Right. Brussels sprout.
I'm actually, but this is my third. I'm enjoying this enormously. It sort of goes quite fresh and lettucey.
You know, it tastes a bit like. I think it tastes like chestnuts.
Bingo! It's bizarre. It's much lighter than a sprout, and it's sort of... I think this could be the saviour of the sprout.
Well, Tom, thank you for bringing us the strangest, most intriguing item that we've had for months.
Can I have the wine without the berry?
Yes.
Later.
Yes, go ahead, have the wine.
Help yourself.
I'll have the Guinness.
Okay.
Okay. What's it called again? Just give us the name of the thing again.
Sensipulum dulficum.
But we call it Miracle Berry.
Miracle Berry will do.
Okay, you can read up about it on the internet, and you can order it as well. Right, as I...